Here on The Break Room, which one of us is the better lie detector? We'll find out. Going on today, Jerry.
So today we're actually gonna try if we can tell if someone is lying and see who is the better detector, John or Jerry.
So we're gonna go through a list of questions, or statements.
Either it's a fact, a scenario, or an event. Oh. As long as it's true or false, we don't know. The other one will actually gonna see or try to detect if it's true
or false.
Yeah.
Okay.
You ready for the first one, John?
Let's do the first one. You wanna go first?
I'm gonna go first. And if you guys wanna join, please write down the comments below for what you think, if it's true or not. But first things first, please don't forget to subscribe, like, and click on that notification button.
Yes, and Cafe 86 is what we're advertising today. We are not sponsored,
but
if you'd like to sponsor us with some free drinks,
or a show,
very much appreciate it.
We just like you guys, that's why we have it here. Cafe 86.
All right, question. Okay. I mean, question. Statement, story?
I'll start with hopefully a basic one.
Okay.
I don't know if it's basic, but we'll see this one. Ants cannot cross chalk lines. So basically, you have a chalk. You see ants, you can actually trap it.
Okay, so okay, I think I've seen ink work.
That they actually trap. But ink is wet. Maybe that's a reason why.
Maybe.
But chalk is dry. That's the difference.
Oh man, as a kid, you know, you play with chalk on the pavement, and sometimes you'll see ants, but I don't recall if I've ever seen it. Okay, true or false?
Is true that a or fact? False? Is that a fact? Or am I just lying to you guys?
Cross chalk lines. This is a good one, Jerry.
I researched this, and hopefully my research is all true.
What's your sources?
Internet. I don't know which one, but...
Was it a peer-reviewed article from us?
I can't vouch for that. But I did see one or two websites that basically say the same thing.
Okay, I guess if it's two, it's true.
Well, the thing is, you don't know if I'm making it up or if it's true through the website.
Okay, well, I'm just gonna go off of the ink, what I know about the ink.
Okay.
And what else?
And your answer is, what do you think?
I say true.
True?
Yeah, true.
Because, give me just a little bit of reason why.
Because ants like lines. They make lines, you know? They follow each other in a line and they're very organized.
Uh-huh.
So I feel as though they're OCD, and if they see a line, they won't cross it. Especially a chalk line.
Chalk line.
Yeah.
That's kind of like an intersection for them and stuff.
Yep.
Actually, John, you are.
Hey.
And your line of thought is actually not that far.
Ooh, okay.
Good job, John. You're a good detective. Dang.
Sometimes.
Mr. Batman here. Deducing all the information.
Tell me what you know.
So, the actual, based on the stuff that I read, you are actually correct because they go through a line, and that line is actually trailed by scent. So their ant scent, so the chemical scent. So if you cross a line on it or a chalk line, you cut it off. So now they cannot move forward because they cannot smell or taste the chemical scent anymore. So they're just gonna basically go, and it's not that they cannot cross it. It's just you block them.
Their smell.
Yeah,
that pathway.
Correct. So they're just gonna go somewhere else.
That's pretty cool.
But John is correct. Good job, John.
Thank you.
Okay, Jerry, you ready?
Yes.
Don't wake up the sleepwalkers, because when they wake up, they don't know who you are, and they will hurt you.
Oh, I don't want to throw my brothers under the bus, but I have a brother that actually sleepwalks.
Oh, okay, well, yes.
Sleepwalker.
Really?
Yes. Based on what I experienced, that would be false. I don't think so, because when I remember correctly, when we were young, they were actually trying to wake him up when he was sleepwalking.
And what happened when they woke him up?
They just woke up. I don't think they remember what they're doing, or they're probably just surprised or confused. So we were that, like, how come they're there when they were sleeping?
What were they doing?
Weird, actually.
I'm just curious.
Okay. So one of them, this is the one I remember. I'm not gonna say which one. But I saw one of my brother, he was he crying? But he was like, not hysterical, but he's like really worried and calling my mom and opening the cabinet and saying, "Mommy is there."
In the cabinet?
Something like that. I might be forgetting some other details, but I know I do remember that he's calling our mom and then he's trying to open the cabinet because he thought the mom's in the cabinet. In there. I don't even know if he's thinking that's the cabinet, or maybe he's in a different world.
Oh, that'd be crazy.
And then like seeing like in VR.
Yeah.
The cabinet is not really a cabinet, but
that's pretty crazy.
That's the one that I remember the most, yes.
Could you imagine that, and he's looking for somebody that has already passed away in your kitchen?
Well, they're...
Would that be scary?
Well, yeah, but a good thing he's looking for my mom.
Who is alive?
Who is the one who's trying to wake him up?
Okay, there you go.
But yeah, but if it's someone he doesn't know or someone passed,
like,
recently
passed,
and then I'll probably everybody would freak out,
in the house.
Yes.
Crazy.
So sorry, I'm not gonna say your name, but I told your story.
It's okay, you're anonymous.
Yeah.
You're correct.
You're correct,
right? They would rather you wake them up because it's for safety reasons, because they can hurt themselves, they don't know what
they're doing. True, because they do. Technically, even though they're walking, even though they kind of know the area, but they're still not fully aware of where they're going.
Right, so it's a safety concern.
Oh, so if you see someone walking
with their eyes closed,
slap their face and then, hey, wake up!
Do they sleepwalk with their eyes closed?
No, it's basically, again, sleepwalker is like they're fully awake.
Wow.
Yeah.
How do you know they're sleepwalking?
Because they're doing weird stuff. Like the one I just told you.
You won't know when I'm sleepwalking.
Okay, John. So in certain instances, hot water freezes faster than cold water.
Hot
is that
water
true or false?
Freezes.
Like hot water.
Like boiling hot.
Yeah, we can put it boiling hot. So boiling hot water and cold water, you put them together in the freezer, the boiling hot water will freeze first compared to the cold water. Is that true or false?
Oh, that's a good one.
Mm-hmm.
Because it sounds like it'll be true, but for some reason I feel like it's false.
Well, let's put it this way. I'll have you kind of like, deduct it. If you choose this, what's the reason? If you choose that, what's the reason? And then just weigh which one you think is the good answer.
Okay. I want to say it's true,
mm-hmm,
but I also want to say it's false. Okay, so true because it's hot water.
Mm-hmm.
And so logically, my mediocre mind.
Yes.
And I'm pointing at my freezer here.
Okay.
I would think that it'll take a lot longer for it to reach freezing point.
Because it's super hot.
Because it's hot.
Uh-huh.
But then I want to think of false because it sounds like a trap. And if I would think about how it would freeze faster when it's hot, the molecules are moving rapidly.
Ooh.
And so they escape as gas, which reduces probably the amount of molecules that need to reach freezing point to form ice. I don't know. What was the question again? I forgot.
So in some cases, boiling hot water freezes faster
than
cold water.
Cold water.
Yeah.
Yeah, and then when it's cold, I don't really have a logic of why it would be slower to freeze.
Because it's already cold, right?
Right.
Yeah, so temperature is just closer to the freezing point.
But they're both in a consistent temperature, or if that's the constant, right? They're both, let's say, at the fridge is set
let's
at
say,
a certain...
Let's say it's minus 18 or minus 20.
So the only difference is the water temperature itself. When you put it in the... So why would the hot freeze faster?
Why would it freeze faster? If it's true, again, I'm not saying if it's true. Again, you're just thinking about it. True or false? That's a good question, guys.
That's very good. Okay.
What do you guys think about it? While John is thinking about it, what do you guys think? And maybe you should try it yourself and then tell us the actual result by doing the actual experiment.
I think that it would be true.
And the main reason is?
It's just science.
That's the answer. Science
what everything. Should be wrong? And it's like, no, that's not science.
So yes, right?
Yeah, I think it would in certain cases.
In certain cases.
Yeah.
Which is, again, that's a disclaimer, in certain cases.
Yeah.
Are you sure?
Yeah. Yeah.
It's actually your try.
Okay!
Actually, when you were explaining it, you're getting it. You're, again, John, it's like this.
Oh, really? Okay.
When you were saying about the molecules.
Yeah.
So the common explanation they're saying is, this is not the main explanation, but the most basic explanation is that it's boiling water. So as you said, evaporated.
Right.
The quantity itself
is lower.
It's lower compared to the cold water.
Right.
So it will freeze faster because it's lower. It's less volume
for it to reach that freezing temperature.
Yeah. So lesser volume, faster to freeze.
That makes sense.
Bigger volume, of course, it's a little bit more, you have to freeze the whole thing.
Right, alright.
That's the most basic one. I didn't go to the actual scientific reason because I didn't understand it.
Hey, that's really good.
Yeah, good job, John.
So, viewers?
Did you get that one? Are you good as a detective as John? Because John was like, nailing it right now. Man.
Your turn, Jerry.
Oh, now I'm this. Hey, guys, don't laugh at me if I didn't get it correct, okay? Yes, John, go ahead.
You ready?
Yes. Okay.
Bats are not blind.
Did they say they're blind?
Huh?
Are people saying they're blind? It's a trick question? Like, bats are not blind? Yes, they're not. Well, hold on. I don't think they're blind. I know they're... If I remember correctly, their eyesight is not as good. That's why they have the echolocation. I don't think they're blind.
What about the...
trying to think what...
The saying, blind as a bat.
I don't even know how that saying come about, to be honest.
I don't know.
It's like, I know about like...
But you heard that saying.
Of course, yes.
Blind as a bat.
Now you're throwing me off. Well, again, if my first thought is like, of course they're not blind. They have eyes. And most animals that have eyes, some of them have bad, really bad eyesight. But they're not blind. Well, some of them are blind though. Like some of the mole, I think I remember.
I think moles?
They're blind.
So.
Yeah, they're blind. I think they have eyes, right?
I don't even... I think they do, but it
because they're underground most of the time. They're technically blind. Yeah, they're censoring their nose and
whiskers.
Yeah, something like that. Yeah, I'm doubting my thinking now. I was like, but I'm gonna go with my first intuition. They are not blind. And I'm hoping it's true.
And why do you say that?
Because based on the documentaries or National Geographic or whatever animal channel stuff that I've seen, based on what I remember, some of them or a lot of them again have poor eyesight, but they're not completely blind.
And that is true. They're not blind. When I was learning in school, I was told that they were blind.
I mean,
did you know that? Did you hear that too?
Well, because I know the phrase or the saying.
Yeah.
But it didn't dawn on me like, why are they saying it? Because again, if you're a kid, you see eyes. Usually, when you see eyes, they have eyes.
Yeah. Well,
but that's completely true though. But again.
Oh, what has eyes but cannot see?
Is it a riddle?
I don't know the answer.
This is pineapple.
It's a real question. Oh. The pits?
Yeah.
The pits?
Good job, Dan. Thank you.
Oh, for that information. Good for you. Okay. What's the next
question for John? When it's raining and you're outside, you'll get wetter when you're running rather than you're walking.
Oh, this sounds very familiar.
So when you're running or walking, it's up to you, whichever one, through the rain, you'll get wetter when you're running and or not while you're walking.
I think I've heard of an experiment like this before. I don't know. I forget the outcome.
You're familiar with it.
I think it was Mythbusters. I think Mythbusters did this.
So what did Jamie say?
I don't remember. I just remember seeing it. I was like, oh, that's interesting.
Mm-hmm. I do remember that Mythbusters, right? That's why I remember this. So they did it, and there is a university that actually did their own study, and they both of them
agreed,
got the same result.
Oh, okay. Confirmed. Alright, so let's see.
So what do you think?
I don't remember the answer that came out of Mythbusters. So let's think about this. Okay, so it's raining.
Yes.
So right now it's leaning towards the running person that's gonna be less wet.
Okay.
Because they're gonna be spending the less amount of time in the rain.
Correct.
When you're running though, so if we have a bird's eye view, a person walking will generally be kind of like regular. It's not going to be huge strides where you're exposing more surface area, right? From up in the sky.
And you're seeing more,
and so
I guess.
You catch more and your strides are longer. But is that enough? So if somebody spends a minute in the rain versus 30 seconds, is that enough to say that the person walking will be less exposed?
We don't know. So what do you think, John?
I think this is a hard question.
So is it true or false?
Okay, so if rain is falling at a constant, and you're running through, what if you're collecting more of the drops as they fall? Because you're like, oh, it's falling, huh?
You're catching more.
Yeah.
Rather than walking, you're only getting the portion that you're supposed to be getting if you're walking.
Yeah.
While you're running, instead of just getting this, you're getting more because you're...
It's like, as it falls, you're... Yeah,
you're kind of like scooping everything that you're not supposed to be scooping.
Yeah, that wasn't for you.
Yeah.
Okay. Because you ever notice when you're driving, when you stop the car?
Oh, this is a different analogy. Okay, let's think about this one.
I feel that my windshield doesn't get as populated with raindrops as when I'm actually driving through the rain. I feel like that gets more raindrops in a faster amount of time.
Hmm.
So...
Is that what you...
I'm gonna use that as my thingy.
Okay. I mean, it's not a bad thing.
When you run, you will catch more rain than when you walk. So the person that was running will actually be wetter. Okay, that's
so
it.
What are you gonna say?
Final answer.
So basically what I said is, you're saying it's false.
Yeah.
Because you get more, you get wetter when you're walking versus to the person who is running. And you're saying it's the opposite. So what I just said is false. I just want to clarify it before
I think
I tell you the answer. Okay. That is correct.
What?
Yes.
No.
It is.
Okay, tell me why.
Because when I remember Mythbusters, that's basically what I got it from.
Okay.
I don't think they're very conclusive on why.
Oh, they weren't? Okay.
I think their explanations, that's basically what we just explained. Mm-hmm. Like, yeah, you're just basically more, again, surface area when you're running. Mm-hmm. And the water or the rain that you're not supposed to get hit, you're basically just running through them and collecting
it
more.
You're catching it, okay.
Yeah. So right. I think that was the idea.
All
because
right.
They were, if I remember correctly, they were surprised too.
Good
job, John.
Woo! You did it. Thank you for watching.
Thank you guys, bye.